Hi everyone, welcome to Eckhart Yoga. I'm Esther, and for this practice, you're going to need two tennis balls and or any kind of other balls. We'll use it to massage along the upper back a bit. And I'm sitting on a block just to be a bit more comfortable to sit on my knees, so you can do the same, or just a pillow, or and you may not need, you can just sit on your heels. And the flow is going to be about loosening out the neck, shoulders and upper back mostly, and of course any other part of the body will also be touched. So let's start. You can just come to a comfortable seat for a moment. And maybe just lift your head slightly as if someone, as if you reach your head up to the ceiling, and then move it back a bit in space so that we are moving the head more in line with the shoulders. It's something you might want to think about doing throughout the day. It's what we tend to do the opposite these days with computers and phones and the way we hold our head. Just take a moment to observe this area of your body. So your neck, your shoulders, the chest. Do you feel any tightness or tension anywhere? Are there any sensations you feel around that area? Does your chest feel open or more closed? And just widening your awareness a little bit, your attention. How are you today? And we're not trying to change anything or feel good. We're just interested. Just be interested in how it is, in the reality of this moment. Acknowledging, witnessing, with loving awareness. So be kind to whatever it is that you meet. Okay. And then you can gently open your eyes on the next in-breath. And we just get going. So as you're inhaling next, you can take your arms out and up. Interlace the hands and exhale, press the palms up. You really press the palms up to the ceiling. You take your little finger back, you take your thumb up. And we just stay here for a few breaths. There is a stretch, but there's also some softness. Your front ribs fall down. You stretch up from the back body. And here too, you just lift your head and you bring it back in space a bit so that we counteract the bad habit of putting our head forward, sticking our head forward. And your breath, you breathe with the intention to open the upper body through the side body, the front, the back. Lifting the ribs off the lower back. Inhale. And gently exhale, release the arms down. And already feel what this does. You can already feel more expansion in the upper body. Inhale, take your arms out, elbows out, and the hands are facing forward and up. And then you can bring on an exhalation the right elbow over the left, and maybe the back of the hands come together, and perhaps you can bring the palms together and move the hands past each other. And here you can just round into yourself. So on an exhalation, come a little bit forward with the upper body and the head, and then begin to breathe into the space between the shoulder blades. Expanding that area. Opening it up with the breath. One more breath like that. Inhale, lift yourself back up. Just for a moment, bring the hands to the left and your ear to the right ear to the right shoulder. Come back up, inhale, other side, arms to the right, left ear. And release. Inhale, bring your arms back out, elbows up, forearms bent, palms facing towards me. And then other arm on top. So now the left arm comes on top, yes. Either back of the hand together or palms, and inhale. Exhale again, bend a little into yourself, fold a little into yourself to create space between the shoulder blades. And that's where we breathe. So it's not a big bend, it's just to access that area. You breathe spaciousness into that area, and on the exhalation you soften it. One more breath. Inhale, come up. Gently bring your arms to the left, right ear to the shoulder, other side. And letting go. Wonderful. And again, feel what this has done. So this already makes a big difference in your upper body. And again, bring your head in position. So just keep reminding yourself to lengthen and to bring the head slightly back. Then we're going to bring the arms behind and we're going to hold the elbows of both arms. So this is what it looks like from the back. And of course, if you don't reach here, you will be reaching anywhere where you can. And you can even, if you're holding on to your upper arms or your forearms, you can just pull a little bit. So you press and pull. So you're, and this really opens around the shoulders. It's a lovely opener. Just breathe gently. And now we're going to change the grip. So if your right arm comes a little underneath the left arm, now the right arm goes above the left arm. And again, you pull a bit the arms apart while holding on and breathe. And once more, lift your head and bring it back a little in space. Front ribs stay soft. And gently letting go. Just take a moment to feel again. You can really feel the body opening and expanding more and more after every movement. Okay, and then you can bring and interlace the fingers. So these are four shoulder openers that work really well. So you can just roll your shoulders back. Not pushing them down, but releasing them down. And then keep all that. Keep your chest open. Keep your front ribs softly in. So you draw a little bit your abdominals together so that you knit the front ribs with the area underneath. And we keep the chest open. Inhale, begin to lift your arms up. And they may not lift very far, and they may come up quite a bit. It doesn't matter. The other thing that might happen is when you can't lift them at all, it could be a bone-to-bone compression situation in your shoulders, and when you hold a belt behind you and your hands go wider, you may be able to lift them up. So you can do that. You can decide to get a belt or a scarf and hold that and see if you find a little bit more ease with lifting the arms. Press your sit bones down, draw a little energy up from the pelvic floor all the way through the spine, through the crown of the head. And again, you bring your head back in space. So lift and take your chin back a bit. Three more breaths, really with the intention to open and ease the body. And let go. And once more, feel. Lovely. And then we come on all fours. We're going to warm a little bit more up. So what we're going to do is bring the hands underneath your shoulders, bring the knees further back, then the hips tuck the toes. So you're in half plank. And so this would be a full plank, but the knees are down. And then we're going to do very, very small push-ups. So nothing big. So you don't go down. It's not the idea to go down, even if you can. You can just move your hands and fingers turn them tiny bit out. Elbows keep moving back and you just come down a tiny bit and you push back up, keeping your abdominals strong, your front ribs knitted in like before. And you even press a little up between the shoulder blades here and then we come down about 5 times, tiny movements to keep the fronts of the shoulders away from the floor. Don't drop your head. Remember moving your head back in space. 3, 4, 5. Okay, that's enough. Then you place your hands back underneath your shoulders and the hips are over the knees. And then we do ribs push-ups. So you're just going to keep your arms more or less straight. There's a bit softness in the elbows and then just sink the ribs down. So it's the shoulder blades come together at the back and on an, and then you press them away from each other. So exhale, inhale. Exhale, sink the space between the shoulder blades down, the ribs, and inhale. Couple more. Okay. Then place your hands a little further forward again. Turn the fingers out a bit and even the wrists out, especially if you experience some aches in your upper trapezius. This may need to happen where your arms are a little wider than you think they need to be, and even maybe the hands turned out slightly. And if this doesn't work for you, you can always come back to the alignment you're used to. Inhale, tuck the toes, and exhale, press back into a downward dog. So this should, the idea to maybe change the alignment of your arms and hands a little bit is to find more ease in the upper back. And you can walk your legs here a little bit to also find ease in the back of the legs. And do it gently, with kindness. Nothing big needs to happen. You're just step by step working with the body. And keeping the mind at ease by staying with the breath, keeping an anchor in the here and now. Maybe come to some stillness in the pose for a moment. Observe what the mind is doing. Where does the attention of your mind go, the energy? And can you remain in the here and now with the breath or with the sensations? Okay. Gently exhale, bring the knees down. And then we're going to take the two balls, if you have them. And you're going to lie down and bring the two tennis balls in the upper back on either side of the spine. So they might even touch each other. They're level with each other on either side of the spine. They're not pressing ever into the vertebrae. You want to stay away from that. And then you can just place your arms down and just roll up a tiny bit. And rest your head on the floor, or if this feels in any way too strong, you may want to rest your head on something. This should not hurt. There may be a bit of sensation going on, that's fine, but it shouldn't be too much. If it's too much, then you can also do this against the wall on this part of the body. So the balls are just at the top part of my shoulder blades on the inside of it and on both sides of the spine. And see if you can, on the exhalation, find some softness. And keep breathing into that whole upper part of the body to bring energy and prana to there. And if one specific area feels too strong, maybe even moving up or down a little bit, you find an area of the body that takes it better. And really, we don't want to overwhelm the body with sensations. So if it's too much, it's too much. You need softer balls, or you need to lean against a wall, because then you can have better control over the amount of pressure. So a massage therapist can hurt you. You can hurt yourself too. So really refrain from sensations that are too strong. You don't need that. And then we can gently move up slightly, so you can do that very gently, so that the balls kind of come to a place that is more in the middle of the shoulder blades. So you've got the top part, the bottom part, and then the middle. So that's where we are now, the middle. And again, you can slightly roll up or down if this particular part feels too strong, just to find a place in your body that feels the body can allow the pressure in without tightening up because it's too strong. And breathing into that part of the back and exhalation, find softness. Let the body mold over the balls. And then you can even go a little further down so that there's the bottom of the shoulder blades just on the inside of the bottom of the shoulder blades. And feel free to have something underneath your head. You need your neck to be comfortable too. Keep letting go. And then you can remove the tennis balls one by one, or just come off them in your own way. Just for a moment, place them in the neck. Just not, again, you don't want to touch any vertebrae on the balls. So they're on both sides, just above your neck, in the where the base of the head begins. And you have to hold them, otherwise they'll roll away. So very lightly hold them, see if you can relax your arms as much as possible while keeping the ball into place. And just release some pressure onto it, only if it feels good. And you can even very gently roll your head a bit from side to side. Just to loosen out the area just at the base where the neck becomes the head. Okay, that's enough. Remove the balls to the sides. Take a moment, feel. Your body might just feel a bit more close to the floor. And then you can rock up to come to a seated position. And again, for a moment, see what the upper body feels like now. Pretty nice. And then we come back on all fours. Do a little bit more. We're done with the balls. And then place your body back to prepare for downward dog. So you can bring your hands a little further forward, turn them out slightly, and have the arms maybe a bit wider than you normally would do. Tuck the toes under, inhale. And exhale, press back. Downward dog. On the in-breath, you come forward a little bit. And then bend your knees, press back, exhale, back to downward dog. Extend the legs again. Inhale, come forward a little bit. Bend and press back. And get into the upper back here. But you keep your front ribs a little sort of knitted in towards the area beneath it. Inhale, lift your right leg up. Feel the stretch in the back of the left leg and enjoy that. You may even need to bend that knee a little bit to take the pressure off. So maybe it's just perfect as it is. But keep it comfortable, whatever you do. And then step your right foot true to the right thumb. Bring the back knee to the floor. Inhale, come up. Interlace the fingers behind. Again, front ribs knit a little in. Inhale, lift the arms and take the head back. Here again, you can use your belt. Breathe in. And exhale, place your left hand down on the inside of the right leg. Maybe lift your back knee if you like. I like the freedom of that. And then you can circle the right arm a couple of times and look over to the right. You can circle it back. And you can circle it to the front. So you circle both ways three times. You can find a rhythm with your breath. And then inhale, take your right elbow up when the arm is back down, and then the arm up and come into a twist. And again here, we stay for a moment and we breathe. Of course, little movements to help the body to open are always okay. You kind of press a little into your right foot and take the weight out of your right hip, pulling the navel a little bit away from that area. Inhale, exhale. Both hands down to the inside of your right foot and bring the left knee down. Inhale, bend your left knee and bring your left arm over to hold on to the left knee. So your right hand is on the inside of your foot and gently bring the foot in. So same foot, same arm for now. And you can lift a little and then your foot comes closer to the bum and then you can find a bit more depth again. Inhale, exhale, place your left hand down and now take your right arm across and hold on to the foot. And now you're going to gently open the chest and come a bit into a back bend. Find your breath. Comfortable sensations, nothing too strong. Keep it balanced. Bring the head back in space. And exhale, both hands down. Step back, downward dog. Inhale, left leg rises. And we stay here for a moment. And remember, you can bend that standing leg. Take a few pulses even. We're just looking for comfortable openness at the back of the leg. So we just want to feel it. Nothing needs to happen. We're just waking it up. Balanced sensations. And then exhale, step your left foot through to the left thumb, back knee to the floor. Come up. Interlace the hands behind. Pull the navel in a little bit and keep the front ribs sort of knitted in with the area beneath. And inhale, lift the arms. Take your head up and back a bit. In space. And here too, again, you can use your belt or your scarf if there's no movement in the arms, which is bone-to-bone compression. It's not something that you fix with flexibility. Comfortable breath. Inhale and exhale. Place both hands on the inside of the leg. Keep your right hand there, lift the back knee up, and we take three circles each way. So you can choose which way your arm circles first. Find a comfortable rhythm with the breath. So on the in-breath, the arm can come up. For example, on the out-breath, down, and then time to go the other direction. When the arm is back down on an in-breath, lift your elbow up. And from there, the rest of the arm stretches up. And we stay. And you may want to change a little bit where you place your feet just to be comfortable and feel. It makes sense to pose. Exhalation, both hands on the inside of the foot. Bend your right knee. And then first, we're going to hold the right knee with the right hand. Yeah, so same leg and arm. And gently lift the hips a bit so you get access to bring your foot closer to the bum. And then you slowly, and of course you've got maybe a block, you can always place your hand on the block, and then you slowly you can lower the hip back down to find a balanced sensation in the upper thigh. Nothing too strong, there's no need for strong. Opening of the body works much better when you do it gently and when you are kind to it. Okay, place your right hand down. Inhale, now take the opposite arm to the foot. Hold the foot, now you can press the foot away a little bit into your hand and find a little back bend. So you open your chest, you take your shoulders back, you bring your head back in space, and you enjoy being here. Exhale, both hands back down, place your block away. And then step back to downward dog. Inhale, come to plank. You can roll into plank. So press the floor away with the feet, curl into yourself, belly in, rounding through the spine all the way till the shoulders are over the wrists. And then you unfold. Inhale here. Move a little bit. Find a little bit of pliability. Doesn't have to be all that static. And then knees down. Roll over your thighs. Come to the floor. Hands underneath your shoulders. Inhale. Open up into cobra. Exhale, fold back down. So keep some stability from the belly through the legs. So there's connection there. And then as you're inhaling, draw the navel into the spine. So you lift up from the belly, then the rest of the body follows head last. And exhale, back down. You can come onto the fingertips and your hands can be anywhere where they feel they support your body in this movement. So that will be different for every body a little bit. So where can you place them so that you feel they are of support to you? And you just do this a few times. And this is not about getting more bent into parts of you that are already flexible, but actually feeling into those places that aren't moving with you and see, can you get deeper into those areas? So for me, there's a part in my mid back that feels stiff and I'm trying to access that part and I'm not bending in those areas that I'm already bendy enough. They don't need it. Okay, and that's enough. Just for a moment, rest your forehead on your hands. And let go as you exhale. Now you can roll onto your back from here. Extend both legs and then inhale, lift your right leg up. Just circle it around for a moment. Three times one way, three times the other way. Feel what you need to do, the stability you have to keep in your abdominals not to fall over. And then on the exhalation, you place your right foot on your left knee, left hand on the right knee. Take your right arm out, inhale. And exhale, bring your right knee across the body to the floor to the left, and maybe your head turns to the right to the arm. And you do not go any deeper than feels balanced and right, okay? You can very easily bring a little discomfort in the lower back in this pose. There's no need. Draw the right thigh bone back a bit in the hip socket, very gently, not aggressive. And my knee is far away from the floor. If I pull it any closer, it's not beneficial for my body. So I just want a gentle stretch, gentle opening while I stay stable at the same time. And my body feels like it's grateful for it. Not that it thinks, oh my goodness, what's happening? This doesn't feel right at all. There's no place where anybody should be, but in the right place for their body, that it feels right. On the out part, you can slide your right foot down along the left leg. Take your arms over the head and maybe bring with your left hand your right wrist over to the left. Perhaps your right foot crosses the left ankle and you come into a half moon bananasana shape with the body. Breathe into the whole right side. So it doesn't really matter whether your legs are crossed or uncrossed or you hold your wrist or not. What you're looking for, the function is that you feel a stretch along the whole right side. Inhale, gently letting go. Come back to neutral and maybe even look up for a moment. That you feel your body's in a straight line. And then it's time for the other side. So on an in-breath, you can bring your left leg up and just circle it around and feel the work that is involved. When you circle the leg, and of course you can do this with your knee a bit bent, to not fall over, and the body needs to stabilize itself. And it does that beautifully. And then you circle both ways. Inhale up and exhale, bend your left knee, place your left foot on the right knee. Take your arms out, inhale. And exhale with your right hand, guide your left knee over across the body to the floor towards, it doesn't have to touch in any way. And you turn your head to the left. So here again, you can draw that left thigh bone slightly back into the hip socket in that direction. And you stabilize the low back a little bit that way. As well, remember the sensations, you want them to feel balanced. So whether your knee gets to the floor or not at all, or it's far away, is not important. You're just looking for a pose that feels balanced and does something for you, not against you. And then you come out gently on the in-breath, roll back. And then slide at the same time your left foot down along the right leg. You take your arms overhead and with your right hand you can hold your left wrist and you can bring your body a bit in a C shape, in a banana shape. So you feel a stretch through the left side of the body. That's the function. So whether your foot is crossed over another foot or not, if this feels not quite right, you uncross the feet. You do or do not hold your wrist. It's what you're looking for is just a gentle stretch and opening along the left side. Nothing too strong. Relax your jaw, breathe comfortably. And let go once more, bring the body back to center. You may even just want to lift your head to make sure the body's straight again. And then we finish with a delicious rocking of the body. So you bring your feet a little wider out and you flex and point, your heels are on the mat. You need to have no socks on because that might not work. Your whole body stays relaxed. The only thing you're doing is you're pointing and you're flexing the feet and you get it into a rhythm so it goes quite fast so that your body moves and rocks forward and backward. And why are we doing this is to relax the fascia, the holding system of the body in which, you know, the fascia holds everything. And you wake up and you stimulate every cell of the body, in every part of the body. Really see if you can also let your head completely relax in your neck so they move along too. So the whole body moves. Jaw relaxed, eyes soft. And next, deep in breath. And as you exhale, let go. Release the rocking. Release all efforts and feel. Stay quiet, do nothing, and feel. Feel the effect. Feel the aliveness in the body, the energy moving through. If you like what you feel, you can always pause the video and do the rocking again. And then come into the relaxation, or you can just let the video continue and I'll talk you through the relaxation now straight away. And you can stay where you are. I'm going to sit up, talking you through the relaxation. So really just let go again. Release all efforts and feel. Allow the breath to soften and become natural. Giving yourself permission to relax deeper and deeper with every out-breath. Soften your heart. And from your heart, feel your whole body. Feel the physical shape and form. The sensations, the felt sense of the body. Feel your body as one. Nothing to do, just being present to what it is your experience in the field of your awareness, whether it's breath or sensation or thought, just don't get caught up. Be the acknowledging, the witnessing, welcoming of your experience. Stay out of the stories, out of thoughts, just observe. Where does your attention go? And then with lots of love, tune into your own heart. Begin to feel gratefulness or be grateful for the body you have, for what it can do and does do for you all day long. And be grateful to the floor underneath you for being there all the time, supporting you. And perhaps you can feel that backrest of silence, of stillness, of energy that is always there to support you, to support your every experience. Always there, never not there. Also when you sleep, it's there. And then you can come back, if you like, by moving fingers and toes and giving yourself a stretch and coming to sit up. Or you can stay much longer and let the video come to an end and just stay for yourself, giving yourself a longer relaxation, as long as you wish, the longer the better. Here, I'm going to say goodbye by bringing my hands to my chest and taking a deep breath and bowing to that backrest of energy that supports all of us and that's bigger than us. Thank you so much, everyone, and I hope you enjoyed it. Namaste.